Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, everyone. May peace be upon all of you. Alhamdulillah, with the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have second wedding today. And the first wedding, they are still there enjoying their food. And you may have seen some brothers and sisters, they are leaving. That means that it is a blessed day. When we have marriage and nikah ceremony, that itself is considered as worship. As in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this is one of the miracles at getting married. So our nikah, our marriage ceremony today will start with the sermon that will be in Arabic. And after the sermon will be ijab al-qubul, that is a proposal and acceptance by both bride and groom, and authorizing me to marry them, and after that, accepting the marriage. At this time, I would like to request one brother to be as close as he can, Brother Jose Navarro. I will start nikah with a sermon. Alhamdulillah. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وقال الله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال الله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وقال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم النكاح من سنتي وفي رواية فمن رغب عن سنتي فليس مني صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Brother Anthony Baptist Spain, son of Roger Henry Spain, do you propose your marriage with the Tajah Bey, daughter of Idrisa Bey? That is going to be with the marriage gift, with the mahar that has been agreed between them, and according to Quran and Sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. And Brother Jose, that you accept that proposal by Anthony Baptist Spain, son of Roger Henry Spain, for your for Tajah Bey.
I do.
And a sister Tajah Bey, daughter of Idrisa Bey.
Am I pronouncing right? Bey?
Bye.
Bye. Mm-hmm. Bye.
Now, do you accept the proposal by Anthony Baptist Spain? And that is with the mahar and the gift mahar that has been agreed between them and according to Quran and Sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him. After this proposal and acceptance, I marry Anthony Baptist Spain, son of Roger Henry Spain, with Tajah by daughter of Idrisa by, with the mahar that has been agreed between them in according to Quran and Sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. After this pronouncement of marriage, Brother Anthony Spain, then have you accepted Tajah by daughter of Idrisa by as your wife?
I do.
A bit louder.
I do.
Those people who are there, that could you hear him?
Yes.
Are you like a bit louder?
Louder.
That is enough?
I do.
That is loud enough. And Brother Jones, have you accepted Tajah by his marriage with Anthony Spain?
I do.
And Sister Tajah by, have you accepted your marriage with Anthony Spain?
I do.
Okay. And at this time, that because we all are here, and if you demand anything from him, $1 million. This is time. He's tied up. He's tied up. If any demand, no?
No.
No. Only him? Okay. That is the verses that I recited in the sermon that was in Arabic. That in these verses, there has been one commandment, there has been one advice that has been repeated about 5 times. These 5 verses. And we know about our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that he was very concise when he used to talk. Sometimes one phrase, 2 or 3 words, and the scholars, they need to explain it in volumes and volumes and hours and hours. But when it comes to marriage, this is the same sermon he used to recite to marry his companions. Remember that, imagine that 1400 years ago in his company, that companions, they wanted to get married, and he was marrying them with the same sermon, with the same ayat. These are blessed ayat and the blessed sermon that I have just recited. And in this sermon, that he repeated one thing again and again, and that was ittaqullah, that have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the scholars, as this is an Arabic word, scholars in different languages, they have explained and interpreted that word with many meanings. It may be that God-fearing, and it may be that God-awareness, and it may be many things, many interpretations. That one thing that is common between all of them, that is dedication. Dedication to our Creator. Dedication to God, that who has created. And he did not only created us, but he is sustaining our life as well. Whatever we need to sustain in our life, that is in abundance. May it be air that we breathe. Without air, we cannot survive. Food, water, that he has given us. And on top of that, the life that he has given us. So these things, they all, we have it. Other than that, whatever we need or whatever we wish, whatever we desire, they are not real needs. They are not real necessities. But it is to comfort our life. Whatever we needed for our life, that He created and He provided us with in abundance. So dedication to Him, that who has given us everything what we need in our life, that is logical. So that dedication, in one of the tradition, when an angel came in human form in front of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and asked him a few questions. One question was, Mal Ihsan? What is Ihsan? What is excellence? So he replied, Anta'bud Allah ka'annaka tarah, that you worship Allah. You worship your Creator as you see Him. And if you are not at that level, so at least that you should feel that He is watching you, that you are in divine presence. So that kind of dedication, that level of dedication, if we have with our Creator, then that dedication, it helps us to dedicate ourselves with each and everything we do in our life. And in these ayat, that has been asked again and again, that have dedication. If you have a job, you have dedication for your job. Those that who have dedication with their job, they are successful. They excel in their jobs, in their professions. There are two students that they graduate at the same time. One has dedication with his profession. So we will see after a few years that everyone knows that person and his excellence and his experience, everyone knows and everyone appreciates. But the other one, that who is just dragging his profession and himself with that job, then maybe that he is doing things but not appreciated. Dedication in our family life. Husband to his wife and wife to her husband, if they have dedication, then that marriage will be successful. And that is what dedication is. Dedication to the one that who has created us. Dedication to serve the community through our professions and through our jobs. And dedication to our spouses through our sacrifice and through understanding them, and to do whatever we can to ease and comfort each other. So if we have dedication, then there is no reason that we are not successful. And this advice, especially at the time of marriage, it is for, especially for bride and groom, that have dedication in your life. When you are eating, dedicate yourself to eating. Enjoy each and every bite of your eating. Taste the food. When you drink, so do the same thing. It will increase our focus. It will increase our dedication. So when we have dedication in our life, we will see that everything that we have in our life, that will turn in excellence. And that is what is advice from our beloved Prophet to the bride and groom and for all of us. So dedication is going to be the key. For dedication, there is no religion. There is no Muslim or there is no Christian. There is no Hindu or there is no Jew. Anyone that who has dedication in his life, that whatever dedication that he has, for whatever that he has dedication for, that person is going to be successful. And that is a guarantee. And that is a promise from our Creator, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with this advice, I would encourage all of you that our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he used to bless both bride and groom with these blessed words, dua. I will encourage those of you that who are able to repeat with me. So please repeat with me. It means that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his blessings upon both of you. And may the husband be blessing for the wife, and may wife be blessing for husband. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep them together for the rest of their life with righteousness. So please repeat with me. Barakallahu. لكما وبارك عليكما وجمع بينكما في خير بارك الله لكما وبارك عليكما وجمع بينكما في خير.
As Brother Anthony, that he has accepted so loud and clear, but we would like him to sign as well. Yes, brother. Yeah. Just going to be there is groom. One more, please. One more. Are you ready, Tajah? Yes, sir. And Brother Joe's has Wally. And as for our witnesses, that after making a supplication and after making dua, is there anything to exchange? Rings? That you may exchange your rings and then we will pray. That rear is binding. You won't be able to get it off. Yes, inshallah. So let us pray for them. Allahumma ya Rabbana laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa li azimi sultanik. Subhanaka Allahumma la nuhsi thanaan alayka anta kama athnayta ala nafsik. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. We pray for them that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put love in their hearts for each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bind their hearts with each other with love. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower joy and happiness upon both of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep them together for the rest of their life with goodness and with righteousness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in their health and in their wealth and their family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless both the families. اللهم ألف بين قلوبهما وأصلح ذات بينهما اللهم اهدهما سبل السلام ونجهما من الظلمات إلى النور اللهم جنبهما الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن اللهم اجعلهما من الراشدين والراشدات والمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات بارك الله لكما وبارك عليكما وجمع بينكما في خير ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. آمين. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Thank you. Thank
you.
Tajah and Anthony, I'm so happy for you guys. I'm really excited about this moment today. I'm glad it finally has come along. Thank you both for choosing me to play what your father, Tajah, would have played. I'm really happy to be that guy for you guys. Anthony, I knew that from the moment I met you that you were a good dude, and I felt really, really, really good things about you and Tajah in the future. I wish you guys success. I wish you guys longevity. I wish you guys happiness, and that you learn from everything that you do, whether it's an argument, whether it's something great like being successful at your business, that you learn and that you always think about Allah first, no matter what happens. Always think about Allah. So, again, congratulations, and I'm really, really happy for you guys. I know you can't tell, but I'm really, really excited for you guys. I feel really good about your reunion. So, good luck, guys.
Okay. Congratulations, Anthony and Tajah, my little sister. You got married. This is so awesome. Wish you guys a lifetime of happiness, joy, commitment, loyalty, just always being happy. Love you guys. So today's a great day. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you guys for inviting me so I can witness this union today. And I love you guys. Thank you.
Congratulations. Congratulations. Love y'all so, so much. And it's such an honor to have you part of our family now, Anthony. So thank you. Thank you, Allah, for having me be a part of our family. And I just want to tell you two both about what love means to Allah, because you guys are both Muslim, you know. Well, no matter what, everything you do for Allah, just make sure you love each other to the end. You're dedicated to each other to the end. When the Imam spoke about Ihsan and worship Allah as if you see him, if not as if you see him, that's the way your love should be. Always know that it's real, that you can see your love, you can feel your love. And the fact that you are Muslim is what's going to bind you always together. So love you so much. So happy. Thank you so much for Anthony being part of our family, loving our sister, and Tajah. We're so happy. It just brought us all to tears just to be able to witness your love. It's an honor to know you both. I love you both. Welcome to the family, Anthony.
Tajah in Spain, I just want to say I wish you guys the very best. Spain, welcome to the family. We're a crazy one, but so are you. That's why Tajah's with you. And I just want to say this is not the end of y'all journey, but just the beginning, inshallah. I wish you the best. Tajah, I am super, super excited for you. I know that you're embarking on a great new journey, and I wish you two nothing but the best. You've been my friend for, it's been over 3 years. I don't even know it was that long, but we encourage one another, we push one another, and we support one another, and I'm gonna be here for you no matter what. Whether you wanna vent, cry, scream, shop. Congratulations, you guys. May Allah bless you with abundance.
I have to say that this is only the third wedding that I've ever been to. And my niece and her husband, not only are they a beautiful couple, they're a very bright couple. And to welcome him into the family is just, there are no words to describe. Every time we've met over my sister's house, it's just been an incredible occasion. But today was just simply spectacular because, you know, I've never been to an Islamic wedding. And again, I have to say, it was absolutely tremendous. Just no words to describe, you know. And this union between the two of them, I wish them all the happiness in the world. And I know that they're going to be happy, and I'm positive they'll be very prosperous.
All right, Dad, so congratulations, Dad and Tajah, on your beautiful marriage. It's a very special thing, beautiful thing. I'm extremely, extremely happy and excited for the future for you two. I see nothing but blessings ahead, and you know, I appreciate, Tajah, how much you love my dad, and how much you treat him and make him feel the special and make him feel the way that he does. That means a lot to me. And, you know, obviously I love you, Dad, for everything. Everything you do, your professionalism. You know, I try to emulate as best as I can. But, you know, I'm extremely excited for the future, and, you know, I can't wait to see what the rest holds for you guys. So I love you guys.
Are we recording?
We are.
Okay, go ahead.
Congratulations to you both. Very happy for you. Wishing you many happy, healthy, blessed years.
Yes. Congratulations, Dad and Tajah. I'm so happy for this new journey that you guys are on. My family's growing bigger and I cannot be more happier. So, congratulations.
It's a beautiful, beautiful wedding. Thank you for inviting. And just wishing you lots of love and happiness and blessings in the future.
Many, many, many blessings.
Congratulations, Tajah and Anthony. I wish you all the best. Inshallah, many, many, many years of just pure bliss and love. May God always bless you guys. And Daddy's here in spirit looking down on you guys and wish you nothing but the best. Love you guys.
Congratulations. I'm so happy to be here to celebrate with you. The love that you guys have for each other is just amazing to me and it's inspiring. And I just wish you the best in your journey in life. And I love you. Congrats.
Tajah, Dad, I'm so incredibly happy for the both of you. I'm wishing you guys both a life together filled with love, joy, support, abundance, all the good things. Tajah, thank you for making my dad so happy and vice versa. You guys are such a beautiful couple and I can't wait for our new life together.
Congratulations, guys. I'm super excited for you. Tajah, I love you so much. And Spain, treat her like a princess that she is.
Is it on? Okay, cool. Check it out. I want to say congratulations to Tajah and Anthony. Such a great event. I was there from the beginning. Now we're here. It's a blessing to see things come full circle. I want to wish you guys many, many, many beautiful nights, many beautiful days, and I'm praying to Allah that He gives you guys beautiful children and gives you guys everything in this life and hereafter. I'm always here for you, your little big brother, but I'm always here for you, and may Allah guide us all, and yo, man, it's on and popping now. It's legal.